Let's do it.
So
you can begin with
it. So what's wrong with your Wikipedia information?
Well, are we rolling now?
We're rolling because मैं अब Wikipedia information नहीं डाल सकता नीचे तो मुझे क्या डालना चाहिए?
अच्छा हाँ नहीं वो अभी भी मुझे journalist कहते हैं which I'm really not anymore.
So, you're not writing anymore?
No, I am, but writing is different from journalism. Journalism fiction, is reporting. Yeah, yeah, I'm not a reporter. I don't go and report stories and bring them to you taza taza. I write actually made up worlds and made up situations. So that's the opposite of being a journalist.
Yeah, yeah. You enjoy that more?
Yeah, it's so much more. It's so much more free, and it's actually the opposite of journalism, because what you're doing is you're inventing a lie, i.e. a story, in order to get to a truth about the human condition.
Yeah.
Hai na? So it's like you write a whole story about two people falling in love and you make it up, but ultimately it's talking about one person's issue and the other person's issue and how they, what that says about just the complication of something as large and complicated as love.
And you also don't have to like kind of insinuate something about an actual individual in life.
Yeah.
So you're free from like, you know, ke फलाना बंदा ये कर रहा है, because when you're writing about non-fiction, you have the responsibility about, you know, the reputation of the people that you're representing within your story.
Yeah.
So
this is true.
So there, it kind of probably gets in the way. I haven't done ever so.
I have to tell you, Mooroo, it's amazing because fiction में होता ये है कि it's a very slow dredging up of your subconscious. So believe you me, I've written 7 stories which you will inshallah finally hold in your hands next year. But ek do stories ki maine takriban 80 drafts likhi hain. 80 drafts. I mean, I'm not even kidding. I've started writing these stories 5 years ago, and some were done in like 30 drafts, which is usually the amount, and some went close to 100. Because that's how slowly you get to know. And I don't mean like writing a full draft and then like writing a wholly new draft. I mean just tinkering with stuff, right? But fiction mein ye hota hai ki what you are is revealed to you via your writing. And what you think is revealed to you via your writing as opposed to the other way around. So journalism mein ye hota hai ki you know what you're going to say, you have a story and you write it. With fiction, I don't think in order to write, but I write so that I may understand what it is that I'm thinking.
Tell me something, when you're doing this is just like to understand the writing process, when you write another draft, do you give yourself like a particular task that you want to make, like, you know, I will make it funnier this time, I will make it more articulate this time? So every draft, do you give yourself a particular task or a bunch of tasks, or you just rewrite?
Well, so I actually do the bland job of rewriting, because I'm not a logical, analytical thinker. I'm actually really not. I am a very, like, Bilal, my husband often gets irritated with me because he'll talk to me about stuff and I'll jump from one thing to another. Like, my mind flits. But that's a very helpful thing for a fiction writer, because you need to make unusual connections with things. So I don't do, like, drafts with a view to, like, fixing A, B, or C. I rewrite, but once my editor sends me her notes, then I do. Then I have to get a little more structural about things.
But I guess, like, I mean, abstract connections to ideas is what makes a fictional writer interesting in the first place, right? There's some sort of connection that you're not even aware of that you've made in your head.
Yeah.
And trying to break that connection down, ke bhai, oh, I thought of time, and then from time, the concept of this came to my head. You don't think that, but you just go to that connection.
That's exactly how it works. That's exactly right. So what I said earlier about I don't think in order to write, but I write so that I may understand what it is that my head is thinking. It's the writing that brings it out. It's the writing that brings it to the fore. Because I'm like, ek cheez ho rahi hai kahani mein, do log kuch kar rahe hain, and then suddenly ek character kuch ekdam se ajeeb aur ghareeb cheez karega, jo meri fingers likh rahi hain, but mujhe nahi pata tha ki wo karega. Aur ye itna romantic lagta hai na ki, ah, my characters, they take me to, my characters are the ones who make the stories, but it's actually true. You know when people used to say it like, I just listen to my characters, and I used to be like, that's so pompous. Oof, I'm sure you're the author, you're playing God, right? You're the one who's moving all the moras. But actually your characters also end up doing funny shit, and you're like, oh, tune idhar jana tha, interesting.
Achha, so you don't have a point A, point B, point C plot at all, right?
मेरे शुरुआत ऐसे कभी नहीं होती मेरी कि ओ मैं ये करूँगी, कभी भी नहीं. आई यूजली बिगिन विद एन इमेज, And the image just then enlarges into a universe eventually.
Ah.
And then I populate my universe with all kinds of things. That's why I'm a very slow writer also.
Okay. I once heard there's this writer who said, follow the fun.
Yeah.
And it was like, also, when you said, I think of an image, it's an image that you're finding compelling for some reason in your head. And then you keep populating that image and you keep going further and further. And whatever naturally, intuitively your mind finds interesting, you follow that path. But it can be a really messy... Like I've done that at times.
Yeah.
And I found like for my little videos, those things can be kind of like has sir pair nahi nikalta unka phir koi aur phir mujhe plot dalna padta hai andar, you know, and I often now I've been forcing myself to do plot more.
So your my instincts for plotting have also improved because I understand the need for it, right? You have to have some hook. You can't just have feeling as a hook. You have to have action as a hook, right? So I've understood that. And I think I've become better at it. But on the whole, like my work, inshallah, when you read it, it's about like small moments and small moments, small epiphanies happening in small moments. And that being the emotion becoming actually a kind of plot device. Mm. So that's what's fascinating about fiction. But masla ye hai ki aajkal hamari brains mein itna thehrao nahi hai for us to actually appreciate the delicacies of emotion. We just want to be stimulated all the time. Yeah. We don't want to do the hard work of actually reading something and having our mind force itself to do the stimulation.
Yeah.
It's a big thing.
Yeah.
I suffer from this also.
Yeah.
Because I know you're a video game junkie.
Yeah, same.
Yeah.
And I often, like, I mean, wo gaur o fikr ka hamare andar maada nahi rana itna ke wo Gabdi sahab bhi yehi baat kar rahe hote hain har waqt ke aajkal ki nasl jo hai wo. Aur Dr. Arfa, do you know Dr. Arfa?
I love her.
She's amazing. She also talks about this. But you kind of see like dinosaurs talking about this mostly. And little kids are just too busy getting stimulated to even pay attention to those guys who know what they're saying.
Or the wise ones rather than dinosaurs even. Well,
yeah. Wrong word. Apologies. So you got married recently.
I did. No, Bilal and I met in March of 2017. So now it's going to be 3 years. It hasn't even been 3 years yet.
Ah.
Jaldi ho gaya bahut.
Was there a time where you kind of like, this is the one?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Hota hai wo.
Yeah.
It's really weird because, you know, everybody says, when you know, you know. Okay? And I always like, I'm always like in my head eye rolling because I'm like, yeah, when you know, you know. Mere saath jab hua, I was like, it was happening in my gut. You know, it was very internal. It was very like, I was changing as a person. I was like, my pores were opening up, like in terms of the way I used to look at the world as an artist. And Bilal was like, encouraging a lot of, and bringing about some of these changes, right? Because he's a very loving, open, smart person. And so when the squiggliness started happening, I was like, oh, I better pay attention to this. And it was, I think it's very much a gut thing.
Yeah.
It is. It's not a rational, logical choice you make. I mean, sure, you can and maybe should also. But it's also just, how am I feeling about this? I actually think that this is good. So, okay.
Like it was there was a point where it had said, if you don't pay attention to the people who are there in your life, you lose them. And like this was a message that she sent. And I was really like consumed with my work those days. So I kind of like took a step back. There was a point where like, you know, like I didn't have what I would consider success. And I was working towards it. And in the process of like trying to get at it, I just went workaholic crazy.
I noticed that too.
Yeah.
I was astonished at the content you were producing, right?
Yeah.
You were producing so much content. I was very impressed, but I was like, ye banda
kuch aur karta bhi
hai. His life is just work.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow. And then I didn't think of burnout because I was like, he must love it. That's how I, you know.
She said, you're going crazy. And basically, I went like, maybe I am going crazy. I'm going crazy for you, baby. And then I fixed it.
Yeah.
So
your shadi, the video that you made on your shadi,
yeah,
it was यू नो मैं अभी बात करी थी कि मेरे पास टाइम नहीं होता चीज़ें, मैंने वो पूरी देखी, इतनी भी कोई लंबी नहीं थी, बट मैंने
18 मिनट, हाँ, बट आई एम ग्लैड आई गॉट योर
18 मिनट्स, सॉ द होल थिंग एंड आई वाज जस्ट लाइक, I mean, then I wanted you to make my wedding video, but I knew that like you would only put so much love and effort into your something that you were doing for yourself, and that's one thing I'm very proud of you for, by the way, for marrying Eeraj and for understanding that she was really good for you, because she's also an artist, you know.
She is, indeed.
And she holds her own, but she's also chill. Yeah. And that's something that I've noticed about her, and I appreciate immensely, because वो अपना काम करती है, वो full funkar है.
हाँ.
You know, अभी जो तुमने मुझे glow room दिखाया है और जिस तरह उसने video में भी तुम्हारी मदद की. But she's also got this real zen going on.
And she's like, so I'm very extroverted, and she's more introverted type. She's like less social. She doesn't want to go to parties much. So there's like a good बैलेंस लाइक पुश एंड पुल के मैं उसको खींचता हूँ, वो एक्सट्रोवर्टेड होती है, वो मुझे खींचती है कि भाई अब बहुत पार्टी हो गई है,
क्वाइट टाइम,
तो अच्छा होता है कि सुबह के 6 बजे तक किसी के घर पार्टी नहीं कर रहे, वो 2 बजे तक घर ले जाती है आपको.
और तुम्हारी मदर इन लॉ तुम्हें केक्स भी बना के देती है.
मदर इन लॉ केक्स भी बना के देती है, एंड शी इज गुड एट पुलाव एंड फूड इज ग्रेट फ्रॉम दैट.
आर यू अ बिरयानी और पुलाव गाय?
यार फॉर यू,
आई मीन I love both. And Twitter पे हमेशा ये पलाव, okay. Twitter पे ये बहस हर वक्त चल रही होती है कि बिरयानी को नहीं कुछ बंदा को बुरा कह सकता.
बिरयानी के बीच में भी तो चल रही होती है कि आलू है या पता नहीं क्या है.
आलू बुखारा नहीं होना चाहिए बस.
वो तो बहुत बैड सीन है.
एकदम से इतना मजा आ रहा होता है बीच में आलू बुखारा चलता है. It's like
इलायची, आलू बुखारा, और वो अजीब मुझे बिरयानी की सबसे किसी लिए पुलाव बॉय हूँ मैं, क्योंकि पुलाव में एक अनएक्सपेक्टेड चीज होती है
लॉन्ग
लॉन्ग
हाँ.
दूसरी वो जो काली मिर्च मोटी सी आ जाती है कड़च, एंड यू लाइक बट यू कैन स्पॉट देम आउट. बट बिरयानी हर बार ही आपको सरप्राइज कर रही है. ये भी डाल
दिया आलू बुखारा, लुक्स लाइक पोटैटोज ना.
ओ मैन, सो आई डोंट लाइक सरप्राइजेस इन माय फूड.
या
बट यू आर अ बिरयानी पर्सन.
I think I'm I both. I just don't know why people have such strong opinions on this. It's like it's food, man.
Why can't we why don't we have to compare just because they both have rice in it?
I guess. Yeah. I guess it's a Twitter thing. I've just seen these debates crop up all the time on Twitter, and I'm
brands
just like,
exploit this.
Huh? Oh yeah.
They know that these debates go on, and then they kind of advertise around these debates because they get engagement.
Right.
And I don't know if social media ke baad se hi hai. Social media mein bada ek hai ki wo ab now you can quantify what sort of narrative will get more engagement, and people will just bombard that. Content, you know.
Well, I don't want to go too deep into this, but I started reading this book about called Surveillance Capitalism, and the essential theory is that we are, this you already know, that we are providing our raw data to companies, right?
Yeah.
For them to essentially monetize it, and so they're not just monetizing our data, but they're actually monetizing our behavior, right? Because they're only showing us what we want to see, and then tweaking the algorithm such that I only see what I want to see and what I search for and things like that. But ultimately what it's doing is it's feeding this larger system where we start living in these echo chambers, right? Which is why polarization bhi bahut ho gayi hai, where we, when somebody disagrees with you, you lose your shit, because you're like, in the world of social media, you don't see that much because you only follow the people you like, and all these big corporations are just monetizing our brains now. So they're modifying them also as a result, and that's kind of scary.
Yeah, and tunnel vision that kind of ends up happening for you, that you will only hear the type of thing that you agree with.
Yeah.
And I wonder, like, does it only, because like in case of things that are polarizing, statements that are polarizing that create more engagement on social media, like outrage culture did not exist on such mass scale before social media.
Yeah.
So there must be some sort of there's an emotional response that you have for certain statements, and those statements get to be shown to a lot more people.
Right. And instantly.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you get instant engagement.
And social media, all it cares about is that engagement. And so things like outrage happen, and half of the time they're irrational people just screaming.
Yeah.
And it's just like whoever's got the biggest microphone, you know, gets heard, and their opinion is already validated because they've got more likes.
Well, but the thing that I've recently discovered is that actually, like, platforms like YouTube prioritize extreme content. And by extreme content, I mean if I search for a video about jogging, right, on YouTube, a tutorial or whatever, then the next time I go on YouTube, it's going to show me running. And the next time I go on YouTube, it's going to show me how to run a mini marathon. Whoa. And the next time I go on YouTube, it's going to show me how to run a full marathon. So what it does every time is, it's not showing you, agar maine jogging search ki hai, mujhe agli dafa abs exercises nahi dikhayegi YouTube. Ya mujhe agli dafa push-ups nahi dikhayegi. Wo mujhe jogging ki jo extreme culmination hai, wo dikhayegi. Uh-huh. Which is the algorithm that it uses for everything. So wow. If you're searching for something dodgy, then it'll show the extreme content of that thing.
That thing.
Because it's basically extreme behavior that gets mileage on social media platforms.
Oh,
so
wow.
That is how the algorithms are designed.
Do you spend a lot of time on social media?
I sadly spend a lot of time on Instagram. Facebook, I don't use. Twitter, I lurk. And occasionally when I'm like irritated by something or something is feels like really stupid to me, then I'll tweet. But yeah, Instagram, I have been sucked into it. Yeah.
Is it the feed or is it the stories?
I feel like out of the three social media, or well, up to Snapchat bhi hai, out of Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter,
yeah.
I feel like Instagram is the most least toxic. Because Twitter pe bahut zyada, there's a lot of just like fighting happening on Twitter all the time, people, because you have words. So you're like, as you said, you're just like, you're wrong about this and here's why, and you're wrong about this and you're that.
And you only have 150 words to say it.
Yeah, and so you make it really crisp and crazy. But on Instagram, it's like images. So images are milder and images are like pretty. And
I find myself watching Instagram just getting jealous, you know?
Yeah.
Like, Mira's got those abs. I used to have those abs. Damn it, Mira. And then I meet Mira and Mira says, I haven't even been going to gym. I'm like, God damn it, Mira. I'm even more jealous. So I'm watching and there's this comparison thing that's happening in my head all the time. And people seem to just be happy.
Yeah, I mean, that happens with me also. I look at like other actresses and I'm like, oh, wow, you're like everywhere. It's obviously working out for you. Yeah. Like, I really admire your stamina. Wow, you know, like, I'm so lazy, I think. And so, bahut hota hai.
Yeah.
But then, you know something, Mooroo, more and more, I'm kind of like, I feel like it's become like a vortex. So now I've learned also, I've developed a way of like being like, the minute I shut it, I'm like,
that's not real.
Yeah, it's not actually real. It's the work that you do that is real.
Yeah.
And that's something that like my book has taught me. Having faith in the long run.
Yeah.
And as Bilal said to me the other day, I was kind of down about something and I was like, you know, about like my acting and stuff. And I was like, I wanted this and then this I shouldn't have said no to. And you know, the usual stuff, like bad decisions you've made. And he was like, look, that'll sort itself out. But what you've done with your book, he's read some of my stuff and he was like, look, just borrow hope against the future. And I was like, yeah. And he's like, you need to borrow hope against the future right now because you are doing something very valuable and you just need to know that it'll pay off in the end. There will be emotional payoff, there will be monetary payoff, there will be like dil ka payoff.
Yeah.
But so just keep that in mind. And I was like, I've been thinking about that a lot and I'm like, yeah.
So like, do you look at like writers' careers and kind of go like, oh, I'm at this point?
No, I don't do that at all. I study prose. So I'll read a book and I'll be like, you're so brilliant. But I don't look at like...
At what point, a point in their life did they write a point?
At what point? No.
I'm not interested in that.
That's so amazing. That means you're quite hung up on success.
It's an issue.
It's fine.
Yeah, is it?
If it's in your issue, you're working through it and you're open about it, it's cool.
I guess I'm open about it. But wohi ke kya kehte hain, is bande ne is waqt apna sex change operation karaya aur sex change operation ke baad is tarah ki filmein banayi. To usse kya asar hua? Personal life ka aapke art pe kya asar hota hai? So maybe I can force like not a sex change operation on myself, but maybe like some experiences on myself to come out of them and maybe like I'll write something different.
I think the more we try and figure out how to like carry all this like depth of experience in us so we can channel it into art, like wo ho jata hai. Tab bhi hota hai when we actually don't really know that we've assimilated so much. And the assimilation is always happening.
Yeah.
Assimilation is happening. So I was telling you before we actually sat down on this table, I was telling you that my book has taken a long time, right? And it's frustrated me because I wanted it to come out in 2018, which it was supposed to. And because of a lot of bureaucratic issues with my publisher, wo nahi hui. But us dauran ye hua hai ki I've grown as a person, right? Like marriage is not huge, but it's definitely something, right? So I've I fell in love. I did a lot of other projects. I traveled a lot in the last 3 years, a lot. And so I assimilated all those experiences. And my writing is all the better for it. Now, I don't want to just keep sitting on my book, you know, but you just assimilate. And the assimilation is really cool because it just, the more you see the world, the more open you are. And the more open you are fundamentally, the better artist you are, I think.
Yeah.
So, Pakistan mein ye reh ke na, you have to watch against the stiffening of your like mental outlook, because idhar thodi wo zang lagna shuru ho jata hai.
Yeah.
Tumhe lagta hai ye?
Haan, mujhe lagta hai main pedantic hona shuru ho jata thoda sa. In that, I'm rigid in my views and my characters come out to be preachy.
Yeah.
You know? That's a big problem.
Yeah.
And I often find myself like when I'm watching European cinema, I kind of go like, whoa, that's like such a broader understanding of human nature than my very limited view. And that limited view is what's making it preachy.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
I do feel that happening and I'm fighting it.
Yeah. I feel that here whenever I come back after being away, I'm like, oh, I don't agree with you. Why are you being judgy? Why are you being weird? And then, you know.
Yeah.
Like if I put up a photo where I'm like revealing, like you said, like if I have my stomach showing or whatever, and there are all these commentators or whatever who come and say like, are you even Muslim?
You know? That question.
Just like, yaar. Ab to main delete bhi nahi karti, because I'm like, I am, and even if I weren't, who are you, bhai?
Yeah.
Who are you to come and like police me like this? Why are you policing me?
How did you feel about like getting married with all the traditions and everything that came with?
Yaar, Mooroo, I had two weddings. So I had one in San Francisco for precisely this reason, because that Bilal and I wanted to do our own little thing.
Yeah.
So udhar humne sirf 100 logon ko bulaya. Aur main sirf isliye keh rahi hu kyunki meri idhar Lahore ki shaadi pe I think koi 800 900 banda aaya tha. To humne udhar bahut maza aaya. We had speeches, my parents spoke, they gave really emotional speeches. Ali sang, my friends spoke, Bilal spoke, and Bilal and I also spoke to each other. And I wept. I wept a lot. And that was really cathartic. And
it was
like,
before or after?
Before. So it was before, and we did that to just feel like we had something to call our own. And then I said to my parents, tusi jo karna kar lo, tusi shaadi kar lo. Because obviously, you know, like, unke liye bhi bahut ye khushi ka mauka hota hai, maa-baap. Traditional maa-baap hai, no matter how untraditional they are in other ways. So then we had that deal where I did my little wedding and then they did this. And so, itni koi rasme nahi hui meri. But तो मैं फनी मोमेंट बताती हूँ. जब मेरी रुखसती हो रही थी तो वो बिलाल की जो साइड की लड़कियाँ थी उन्होंने गाने गाने शुरू कर दिए, वो जो रुखसती के होते हैं कुछ. सो दे वर लाइक, एक उसमें जुमला था राज करेगी, और वो बार बार गा रही थी और ये राज करेगी. तो मेरे अबू ने बिलाल को हग किया और कहा, ऐसा राज करेगी तेरे दुख नहीं देखे जाएंगे, तेरे आंसू नहीं देखे जाएंगे. आई वाज स्टैंडिंग नेक्स्ट टू हर एंड आई वाज लाइक, ये कोई मोमेंट है? मेरी रुखसती हो रही है, यू नो, मेरे सर उधर कुरान पकड़ा वैली ने, एंड ही लाइक, ऐसा राज करेगी तेरे आंसू नहीं देखे जाएंगे. आई गॉट सो पिस्ड. आई वाज लाइक, अबू, एंड ही लाइक, it's a joke, learn how to take a joke. And Bilal is like, just relax.
I think wo man to man jokes hote hain ke wife's always right,
but like, maybe I had overstayed my welcome in my parents' home also, who knows. You know,
I doubt it.
I mean,
and they're gonna miss you.
I mean, I don't know.
That's a it's a wonderful house. It's gonna be strange without you. But you still
well, no, I mean, now I go and visit them and it's much nicer now, because I'm a visitor now, and I have this, like, it's nice to be, have that like gray area where you're
in Karachi.
Yeah.
And mostly. Sometimes in Lahore.
Yes. And sometimes in California.
Yeah. And Ali's sometimes in New York.
And Ali's mostly in New York or Lahore. That's Ali's deal. And then he travels for his work. So that takes him all over the place, which is really fun.
So you're doing dramas as well.
Yeah. Still.
Hum pe chal rahe
hain. Haan, mera aajkal chal raha hai, ye dil mera.
Are you playing negative character or positive character?
Positive. Positive, and she stands up to the man. And
hell yes, that's negative actually now.
No, it's now positive, really enough. Yeah, now it's positive.
Okay.
Yeah. Negative is just like somebody who's negative. In the context of Pakistani dramas, negative is like somebody who's committing infidelity, or somebody who's like super, super confident, sadly. That's perceived to be kind of negative. But somebody who stands up to like male aggression or male brutality, that's not perceived as negative anymore, which is really good.
Yeah, which is good.
Yeah.
That needs to change.
Yeah. Something really cool I found out about Hum TV is that, in fact, I found out while I was shooting Ye Dil Mera, you're not allowed to show a woman being slapped on TV. So you can build up to the moment, but you actually can't show a woman being slapped, which is so incredible.
Huh.
Yeah, because there's a statute against it in their policy.
So what do they usually do? Just you hear
they
a
cut
slap?
It. Well, ek to they try not to show that kind of physical violence, but cut kar dete hain. So they don't actually...
And the next day, she's got a mark on her face.
Well, maybe. But the idea is to not show that, to encourage physical violence. Because that is the ultimate thing. If you show it, you normalize it. The more you show it, the more you normalize it. And the point is to not normalize violence.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I often wonder whether like showing something or talking about something is really normalizing it.
In the context of our society, showing where actually a lot of men hit their women, and we are hearing a lot of stories about this in high-profile cases also.
Yeah.
Verbal abuse to hoti hai. Matlab verbal abuse to set pe bhi ho jati hai. Director aur actress ke darmiyan ladai ya actress ya T-boy ke darmiyan, spot boy ke darmiyan ladai. Wo to chalti hai, and you see it, and that's been normalized. That's also wrong, but it's been normalized. Like we fight. I fight with my husband. He fights with me. I fight with my parents. Whatever.
Yeah.
But physical violence, which is way more traumatic, right? Also has been normalized in our serial, where a woman gets slapped and then her mother-in-law says to her, sabar karo.
Yeah.
Sabar karo, beta. And her own mother says to her, sabar karo. Aur wo phir sabar ka journey shuru hota hai. And basically, it's a self-flagellating journey where she's just like punishing herself and looking inward and saying, mere mein kya masla hai, mere mein kya khami hai. And mard, theek hai.
Yeah.
Toh wo normalized bahut hota hai, yaar. So it's so funny, after I wrote this book, I was like, oh, I basically I only know how to write one type of female character, a strong female character. Huh. And when I sat down to write my book, I had no idea. When the book was finished, I was like, oh, this is so interesting. Almost all my female characters are strong.
Is that a limitation you feel as a writer?
No, I think it's a great thing. Because now in the context of an internationally published book, it'll be like, this will tell the other story of Pakistan, right? Which is strong women who are struggling to be carve a place for themselves in the world and in life. But it goes back to my earlier point, which was about meri upar andar se aaya hai ye maine soch ke nahi likha tha warna main pamphlet likhti main fiction na likhti na.
Do you see a little bit of a reflection of yourself in those characters?
I think so,
yeah, because you're a very strong female character.
That should be my bio, strong female character.
Strong female
that's
character.
So good. I'm gonna do that actually.
Theek hai, strong female character. Oh my
strong
god,
strong female lead. Yeah. Do you enjoy living in Karachi? You've been here for so many years now.
Wohi na ke you get your system set up. Like I come here, I know exactly where my laptop is lying. I know exactly what to do when at home.
Yeah.
Plus I've got two cats and a dog to take care of.
You have two cats now.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Do they get
we
along?
Just neutered one of them yesterday because she was getting all... like, all night.
Yeah.
Just like... and male cats are just crazy.
Yeah.
Female cats are still like... you know, manageable. But male cats ki aggression aana shuru ho jati hai. And then they look at and I'm like, okay, not me, man. So I got her neutered yesterday. So there's like a life here.
Yeah.
And when I go there, I kind of still feel like I'm abbu ke ghar mein reh raha
hoon. Mujhe bhi yahi lagta hai.
But jana padega at some point.
Tum jaate, matlab when you visit, you stay with them, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. And your room is still Mooroo's room,
it's
right?
It's my section. We're building it.
Wow.
So the thing is that I'm the only son, na?
Yeah.
So at some point, I'll have to go.
Oh.
I have to take care of them.
Acha, okay.
At some point.
Because your daughter got married recently.
My sister is getting married.
Okay.
Next month.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
And she's not going to live in Pakistan.
Uska plan abhi wo Berlin mein.
Acha.
And the husband to be the fiance is also in Berlin.
Okay, theek hai.
To wo Berlin se aayenge.
That's why you have to be home, basically.
Yeah. It was always the plan. Even when I graduated from college, I was like, do I work here in America?
Yeah.
Or do I come back and start building? So I was like, if I build like a network here in America, then I go back and reset and then build another network there. Might as well stay there.
James Baldwin, who's an amazing American writer who I love, a black American writer, he also said that you don't take your roots and plant them someplace else. There is a version of home. And if you're smart as an artist, you must not exploit, but must use that as material.
Yeah.
I identify with that. Because it's in you, na? So if it's in you, then... creative cheezon ke liye amazing cheez hai.
Yeah.
It's already in you.
It's in you, and your narrative will always come from that place as well, right?
A very real place. Yep. Yeah. Totally.
I remember like writing scripts when I was in college. Oh, Badshahi Masjid likh di, to keh rahe hain ki yaar kis tarah karenge bhai? Tumne Urdu mein likhi hui hai. I was like, I have script likhni hai to real main kis tarah sochu?
Yeah.
C.S. Lewis said this. He's like, I can only write three types of characters. And one is the guy that I am. One is the guy that I want to be, and one is the guy that I hate.
Uh-huh.
And it's the three types of characters that he can write. And all of his stories, he felt like were like that. And he says, when I read Dostoevsky, he can be any character. And and that's why he stopped writing. He wrote his last book. And
really?
Yeah, and that's like in one of his interviews, he said that.
Mm.
And I often wondered, like with my own writing, with characters, I tend to have that, I despise that type of homophobic character, you know, that I've, the toxic boy from Hitchison.
Yeah, but it's in you because
I was that guy and I grew out of it.
Yeah.
So I can access him,
yeah,
but I hate him.
Yeah.
So the writing from that existential vein is like easy to go through.
Mm.
And so all of your short films are from one female perspective, or...
Short stories, sorry, I'm fumbling a lot today. No, it's they're from, some of them are mostly they're narrated from the female perspective, but I have two or three narrated from the male perspective. I think I have two narrated from a very full male perspective, yeah.
So how did that feel?
It's
like being your father or your brother, like people that you know
actually
really
very
well?
Different. They're both not my father or my brother. Actually, my poor father doesn't even make his way into my fiction. And it's interesting because he was not really around when I was growing up because he was very busy all the time. He's very sweet, but he was not around.
Mm.
So I don't really... A lot of my male characters in my fiction are also absent. It's interesting.
Uh-huh.
I've given away a lot about my book, but it's not like these are like...
It's like a synopsis to a movie. You still watch the movie.
Yeah, yeah. So no, they're not based on like my dad or my brother. They're very different.
So do you think of actual people when you're doing this?
I maybe think of prototypes sometimes. So one is about like a university student, right? So then I thought of like some kids at PU who I know a little bit.
You model into an archetype.
Yeah.
And then change things about them.
Exactly. Because the story demanded that. That's my one story that actually has an interesting plot line, weirdly enough. And maybe it's maybe because I didn't have such a huge grip on the character, that's probably why my plot was so strong. Because my emotion, I didn't have such confidence in the character. So my plot was really good in that story.
I often wondered how to come up with new characters, and this is one of the reasons why I want to meet new people, and this podcast helps in that as well, right?
Yeah.
You meet new people.
Do you ever invite people who you don't already have a pre-existing relationship with?
Like Ari Bazar, I didn't know him at all.
Okay.
And people that I kind of like meet in a professional capacity, and I feel like there's a rapport.
Yeah.
I'll call them over. You were good with people, huh?
I think I used to be better, probably. I've become a little more introverted as time has gone by, weirdly enough.
It's the writing?
It's the securing of my private space that I value greatly now that I am very genuinely in the public eye.
Huh.
You know, when you were talking about Eeraj and the moments that you have that are private and low-key and low energy, because I have such a high energy life, when I'm on my own now, I value those greatly. For example, right now I'm on my own, living alone in my apartment in Karachi. Bilal is in Berkeley because he's had to go back for work. And main phone pe Bilal ko keh rahi thi ki mujhe, I'm going to get very lonely being all alone.
Yeah.
And I'll miss you in the apartment, and I'm gonna just feel really weirded out. And he said to me, go and try it out. You might not. And I was like, pata nahi yaar, I'm full drama kar rahi thi before coming. This is the first time I'm living alone without him in this apartment, in my Karachi apartment. I came in, I opened the door, my flight got in at like midnight. And you know, it's an eerie time at night when you come home at like 1 a.m.
Yeah.
Checking into an apartment that historically you've been with someone. I checked in, and the apartment was very clean because we had cleaned it. And I was like, oh, this is home.
Yeah.
And then I've been messaging him saying, I'm actually really enjoying being on my own. Aaj main restaurant bhi akeli chali gayi.
Oh, wow.
Tum idhar aane se pehle.
Yeah.
Akeli gayi. Aur usko tasveer bheji aur maine kaha, I'm all alone and really enjoying it. And he was like, ha ha ha, you're hilarious.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so I've enjoyed my alone time a lot now.
Yeah.
And I didn't even know that about myself.
What are the main things you do when you're alone? Read books and
stuff? I recharge.
Uh-huh.
I spend time.
Oh, yeah. Do you have the thing that tells you how long you've spent on Instagram a day?
Yeah.
What's the average looking like?
I don't look at it.
You don't look at it?
It's scary to look
guilty.
At it. It's scary to look at
it. Yeah. I've put a little thing
although
on
Although my
it.
Phone
like
use has gone to 4 hours a day, which is terrible.
What's 4 hours a day?
My phone use.
Phone use.
That's quite
that's
a lot.
Not too bad.
It's a lot.
It's a lot because you're very strict about it to
no,
yourself.
No, because
but
4 hours
most people are 8 hours.
What?
Yeah, like I compared with
so
like a bunch of YouTubers yesterday.
So half their waking exist life.
Yeah. I was at a cricket World Cup, cricket cup, YouTubers cup yesterday with all these YouTubers, and a lot of them were on their phone throughout the cup.
Yeah.
And I was like, what are they doing? And I would notice that, oh, they're going through pictures of on Instagram of other people and stuff like that. And I was like, okay, so I'm observing the behavior. Yeah. And then at some point I got them all together. I was like, let's open this.
Yeah.
And most of them had 8 hours. And mine was like at 3.
Oh, nice.
Or something.
Yeah.
And most of it is YouTube. Okay. And what I'll do is I'll play a podcast.
Uh-huh.
And
let it run.
And I'll just, you know, so I kind of go, it's fine. Uh-huh. It's not too bad.
You're, at least it's not screen time, yaar.
It's not screen time. Yeah. It's not like you're completely...
Dude, honestly, today at the restaurant, because I went alone, the waiter started laughing because I was just in my phone. And I was like, main phone ke saath hun, so I'm, you know. Yeah. But I was there for 45 minutes. Khana kha rahi hun, and I'm on my phone. Khana kha rahi hun. And then I was like, yaar, this is pathetic. Then I put my phone down and I was like actually like enjoying my food. But yeah.
But if my significant other is not engaging me, then this is the best, next best thing. I'll go right here.
Dude, when you fight in public, kabhi ho jata na, ladai ho jati hai when you're in a public place. Then we've had moments where then we've just come out of a fight and we've gone and sat somewhere. And then we're both on our phones to calm everything to, until the energy calms down, you know?
Yeah.
And then, because that's also like, it's, you're on your phone, so it's nothing bad.
Yeah.
But then we generally, it's not cool because then you're just, then what's the point of going out to dinner? But you were asking about recharging. Yeah. So like when I'm alone now, I just like lie around a lot. I read, I like drink, make myself these like nice, like I make myself hot water with lemon. I'll drink a lot of it. Mm. It's just like calming, detoxing, not engaging with stuff, and I find that I'm really enjoying that alone time these days.
Yeah.
I went to Liberty Market to go shopping with a friend, and we went for an hour. You know, good old Liberty Market, man, like bangle stalls. Yeah. And we went for an hour, and when I was sitting in the car, I had a splitting headache. And I was like, I didn't drink water today. I was like, no, you drink good water today, because usually dehydration se mujhe sar dard hoti hai.
Mm-hmm.
And I couldn't figure it out. Then like when I went home, I was like, oh, it's because of all the pollutants in the air. Because they're so toxic that they go and they give you headaches. And I was like, shit, man. Because usually I'm not in Liberty ghanta ghumti, I'm at home. Yeah, I'm like going for a shoot or something. But it's bad, man. It's
really bad. That was really loud as well. Do you want to say anything before we sign out?
I want to say that this was really enjoyable because it was very free-floating.
Yeah, na?
Yeah.
I feel like I had to do nothing.
That's so cool.
Like I just asked you a question and I got great stories out of it.
But that's enjoyable. That's what you do with everyone. It's really fun.
Yeah.
Because you know, interview में बहुत वो होता है. अच्छा मीरा जी अब ये बताएं. Foreign like I'm like.
Or you have only 5 minutes.
मुझे एक आंटी कहती हैं आपकी मोरू के साथ videos बहुत अच्छी हैं मोरू के साथ. I was like मोरू के साथ करने और काम करना चाहिए मोरू.
Well, thank you so much for coming. You are, we should wave these guys.
Oh,
bye bye.
Thanks guys. बड़ी हिम्मत है आपकी to sit through fiction and all that stuff.